Hi, I'm Cristiano Galvão from the Excel Turbo, and the topic we are going to cover in this lesson is the Ideas. You will learn how this new feature of Excel can help you make data analysis in a very easy way and in a very short time. Let's open Excel, and I'm going to show you where is located the Ideas firstly. Let's put some zoom here, and now I can see and show to you the Home tab where is located the Ideas button. This is the place, and the Ideas is described as discover more about your data. Ideas looks for patterns in your data that it can use to create intelligent, personalized suggestions. Let's see how it works, and you have to have data. You must have data to work with the Ideas, but don't worry because it contains a button to try a sample data here, as you can see it better right now. You have to have the Excel of the Office 365, the subscription system, instead of the old versions perpetual. Let's zoom out the screen, press the try sample data, and then we have here a table where you can use to have the insights. I'm going to show you quickly the insights because I have something more complex to show you after this exercise. But here we have the sales. It's a summary of the sales by product. You can see the sales of tires and tubs, locks, tights, lights, and others. We have also the increase of the sales, and this is a chart based on a pivot table that you can manipulate to see other details that maybe are not described here on these insights. But it's good to know that the sales are increasing, and we wouldn't be able to see just looking to the data set. This is much better to see and understand what is going on. And we see other details here about the sales increasing over the time, and also a trend line to show better the increasing. And for example here, accessories has much higher sales than the others. So accessories, clothing, and components, and bikes. We have 9 more insights to see here. Let's show all the 9 results remaining. And we can see lots of interesting data from here. Again, this is the time that you pressed the try sample data and you didn't know anything about the data set, but thanks to insights, you are able to see now and understand lots of things that you wouldn't be able to see just by the data set. And now, let me show you something better, even more complex. It's a data set from an open database that I'm going to make the download right now. Take a look. Let's see the new data set that I'm downloading right now. And the first tip that I give to you is to save as a binary file, because maybe you will have to open it again and it will open very faster than the CSV. So I'm going to use the save and then binary file, and I'm going to save over this example that I had before. So I'm going to overwrite it, okay? For you, it will be the first time, so no overwriting message. Well, let's do the job now, and I'm going to press the Ideas button to see what happens here. But before to press, let's take a look on the size of this data set. I'm going to press Control Arrow down, and then zoom in here. We see that we have, oops, you are not looking. And now you can see we have more than 200,000 rows. This is too much for the common standards of small business or even medium-sized companies. Let's zoom out, Control Home, and let's see what we can do with the Ideas now. I'm just pressing now, and here above my head, we see that we have too much data to use the Ideas. I can say to you the amount of cells that you have to have in your mind when using the Ideas. 2 million cells. If we have more than 200,000 rows, I shouldn't select more than 10 columns. So, zooming out here, closing here, let's try to select only 10 columns from A to J. If we make a selection, Ideas will try to analyze only this piece of the dataset. Ideas. Now I know that it's running. I don't have the error message anymore, but I have to tell you that depending on the speed of your computer, you will have to wait maybe a little more than 1 minute. That's a good deal, because if you had to make the data analysis by yourself, you would take much more time than just 1 minute. 1 minute is the time to get a coffee. Let's speed up a little bit. Here we go. We have some nice insights of the data set. Look at this. Just expanding the panel, we see that we have more inactive than active business. We can see this same type of insight by a chart, and we can insert this on the data set. The Ideas creates another sheet, and then we can see the report, which is a pivot table, a small pivot table, and we have the business here. We could grab another column, maybe industry, and put here. Not good. Maybe removing the license type, but it's too much. Sometimes it's good to trust and use the insights given by the Ideas, as you can see here. I'm going to delete here, and let's see what else we have here on the insights. We have some outliers. Let's take a look. The outliers are related to the license expiration date. Let's close this. We may suppose that they are ending on this year, but it's always a good idea to pass the mouse, move over the data point, so we can see here that it's actually the next year. So this is a good thing to have, because they are not expiring now, only later. Okay, good outlier. We have more 10 results. It's always a good idea to take a look here, as you can see, because maybe you can think that you have only a small amount of ideas, but you have more. This is interesting. It's saying that with a great distance, we have a large amount of business open inside this category, home improvement salesperson. This is very interesting, because we know that this category is very far ahead of the others, and probably because it's New York City, everybody wants to grab some money from the real estate market. And we have others or other ideas. We can insert or just take a look through the panel. By inserting, we can stretch the charts and see better sometimes. Look at this. We have the names of categories and not inside the panel, so you can see better and make another kind of analysis by changing something on the pivot tables. It's really good, really interesting. Remember that I know this database because I was using it before, but you can access the same data that I provided the way to you. This is not the link, but the way of searching by Bing or Google, New York City, open data. And you have other sources of free open data sets to use. And I suggest you to get some new data to work not only with the Ideas, but the other tools that you have inside the Excel. Let's see. We have other kinds of ideas. All the ideas are very interesting, but we have also some limitations. When you think that, you know, you cannot use all the data set because of the limitation, the amount of data. So maybe you find this interesting, this, this, and this. I'm using the control and clicking the letter of the columns. If you press the ideas don't support multiple ranges. Not today. So, what we have to do? It's a better idea. It's funny. It's a better way of working. Make sure that you are able to see the labels. So, I'm going to use the wrap text and center, both horizontally and in the vertical side. I'm going to use this. Let's increase the size of the columns a little bit, just a little bit. And I don't want this, so I'm going to select the column using shift button at the keyboard, and I'm going to move to here. It's a very smart way to press the shift button when doing the movements of the columns. So it's like a switch, but it's not actually a switch. It's like cutting the column and inserting in the middle. I like this and this. So I'm going to shift to here. I don't want the business name. So this goes here. The street name, secondary, zip, phone. I don't want this. I'm using shift to move better the columns, so I make sure the more relevant columns are to the left. The most relevant columns are to the left. And I want this detail, latitude and longitude. Remember that if you try to get multiple columns, you cannot use the shift movement, but you can do that when using continuous columns. So I'm going to press shift. And I'm going to put here. Okay. And I have more than 10. I have to choose what I want. Business name 2 and address building I don't want. So this. How many interesting columns do I have? Maybe removing one. Address borrow. Okay, let's work only with this and detail because I cannot pass of 10 columns. So I'm gonna stop here and press the ideas. Look at this. This is another kind of message error. This is not about the maximum columns. So when you get this message, you have to stop, save your work, close your file or even the Excel. It's better to close Excel and then you open it again. Then I just press the ideas. This is very important when handling large data sets. And now, depending on the speed of your computer, you can wait maybe 1 minute to analyze a huge data set like mine. And here we go with other awesome insights. The home improvement salesperson and also contractor, the tobacco retail dealer, secondhand dealer, electronics. You can see here the main categories of business of the New York City by the rank. Look at this. This is very interesting. And the less frequent, let's see. Boating company, ticket seller business, amusement arcade, a bingo, or car wash. That's true, we don't have too much. Then, so, we have other insights, and by doing this kind of selection and the trick of reopening the Excel file, you have more possibilities of insights with large data sets. You have all these kind of insights to work with the database that I suggest you to download. I'm Cristiano Galvão from the Excel Turbo. I hope this lesson has given you a great overview of the ideas. If you have any questions, please take a look inside the resource section for the contact information. Thanks for watching.